This week on Mario Maker Mondays, we've got a few courses from Welsh Yahoo based on Mega Man 2. We've got a few crazy courses that I can't possibly beat in a million years because it involves kicking a wall and grabbing a P block 3 or 4 or 5 times in a row. It's ridiculous. Plus, we've got a few levels by the creator of Cooper Road. We've got some levels by people who came into the chat, and it's a lot of fun. I die a lot as usual, so let's get on with the show.
I'm looking forward to this. I'm immortal Mario! We live, we die, we live again! Can I go down there? No. Witness! Oh fuck! Shit! Shit! Oh no, I'm dead. Oh. Yes! I made it out! Oh! What? That was awesome. Skill. Oh! Oh no! Oh no, no. Oh shit. Oh. I managed to make it out using the old flash wire dash technique. Damn it! Oh. Yeah, die, hammer bro, die. This is like literally one of the most fun games I've ever played, Mario Maker. It's like everything you love about Mario, but just with like much more of it, basically. Like, I've played at least a whole, like, game's worth of courses just on this show alone, let alone, like, in my spare time. Alright. Get the fire flower. Shoot the fire. Shoot the fire. Fire. Bring the bird. Oh, yeah. That's how you do that. Let's go in the door. See what's inside. Ah! Whoa, shit, what's next? Oh, okay. That's actually still a platform down there. I will ride into the gates of Valhalla, shining in chrome. You've never seen any of Mad Max movies? You need to see them, dude. Can't believe I just died right before the gate there. Yeah. Right before the gates of Valhalla. Most of the quotes I'm doing are actually just from Mad Max, Fury Road. That's the one that's most prevalent in my memory right now, because it's the one I've seen most recently. But, Road Warrior is actually probably my favorite, honestly. Just because I feel that, it does more justice to Max as a character. Whereas he's definitely the secondary character in Fury Road. Which does not make it any less of a good film. I just personally prefer it when you focus more on your protagonist than on your than on anyone else. Anyway. I don't know. Fury Road is an amazing film. I'm never gonna deny that. But I just prefer Road Warrior. Also, I just think, as much as I hate to admit it, Mel Gibson did a better job of playing crazy, which is not that hard. I mean, he's Mel Gibson. At the end of the day, he is a cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs person. So not hard for him to play a person called Mad Max. You guys should definitely check them out. They are awesome, awesome films. Ah, bugger. Especially if you like retro 80s stuff, come on! Oh, yeah!
I did it! I did it! Yeah! Yeah!
And give that one a star. Thank you for that one. Well, holy shit. Oh, I think I just got what I gotta do. Wow, that was confusing. Alright, let's start over that one. Start that from the beginning. Alright, so I gotta punch the P block and then jump and kick. Oh shit, this really is Get Rich or Die Trying. Alright. Come on, bouncing. Oh yes, there we go. Oh fuck! Well, fucking hell, like, what the fuck am I supposed to do there? Get up there quicker. Apparently only one person is beating this course, so... Oh, good God! How the fuck do you do this? I think I'd rather go 10 rounds with Mike Tyson. I'd rather give birth to a pyramid. Just imagine that image. Down. What the fuck am I supposed to do there? Maybe we gotta land exactly on the P maybe? And then it... what the fuck would I activate then? I have a phone vibration right now. Give me 1 second, guys. I know I'm gonna die here. Oh, I'm dead. Yeah, I'm dead.
Oh, no!
Dealing with all this. And of course, is that I have no idea just what the fuck to do. Like, the guy who made this. Good lord. Shit. Well, I have no idea what to do there, so I guess I have to start over again. Bugger! This is not an easy fucking course. Bounce and bounce and bounce and wall kick and wall kick and wall kick and down the pipe I go. Like, just what in the hell am I supposed to... I have no idea what to do here! What the fuck did... I have absolutely no idea what to do. I'm gonna get the guy who made this course in here. We are... Okay. I gotta get this guy, the guy who played, who made this course in here. Hang on. How? Playing it now? I feel like a fucking Dr. Seuss rhyme. But no idea how to beat it. And I don't mean the Michael Jackson way. .tv/Petros of Sparta. Oh yeah, new layout this week, by the way, because I realised it was impossible for anyone to watch what the fuck I was doing! Because you couldn't see where the fuck the course was going. I mean, unless I could take this down the pipe with me somehow, but I you can't wall kick while you're holding something. I wonder if you can even wall kick if you've got something on your head. I got fucking nothing. I have no idea how to beat this course. I have absolutely no idea how to beat it, what the fuck I'm doing, how the fuck to do this. It's just a fucking nightmare. Like, bugger! Like, this doesn't seem logically possible. Like, I'm wondering if there's what, like, there are some courses that just, like, have a trick entrance sometimes, or, like, some shit like that, but. What the fuck am I supposed to do here? Oh, we just got another course submission from Welshy. Oh, no. I mean, no, I just have no idea what to do here. I could try landing on that thing, on that. But that does nothing. That does fucking nothing. What the? I got no fucking idea what to do now. Oh man, I need coffee. Why do I always stream without coffee? God damn it! What the f- I have no idea what I'm doing here. Like, there's gotta be a secret to this. There's gotta be some kind of secret to this. Have no idea what to do here. Like, I have literally zero idea at this point. Yeah, I have no idea how to beat this one, so I am gonna have to move along. But I have a whole bunch of ones from Welshy Who, which I'm now gonna post below. He's tweeting at me. Tweeting at me. You have to carry and wall jump the first peak. Oh, good lord, how the fuck do you even do that? I mean, is that physically possible? I guess it's technically possible. I just kind of did. Oh my lord, like what the fuck? You have to carry Ed Walsh up the first P switch to the top of the pipe and hit it again. Either there or inside. Like, this seems next to impossible. Oh man, I can wall jump one. I just throw it out the fucking window. Nope, nothing happened. Oh man, this is fucking hard as balls. This is harder than a pervert's dick at a strip club. Bugger! Fuckity fuck! Fuckity fuck. Don't go back. Oh, yes! Oh no! Oh. So it is physically possible to do this, it's just fucking hard. Oh, so close. I've got a two now. Let's try and do three. Fucking hell, this is fucking hard as dick. You are my new sky climb, sir. You are my new sky climb. Oh, bugger, that's already done. All right. Oh. Come on. Ah, my fingers just do not. I'm 27 years old, my fingers do not move this fast. Ah! God, I'm getting fucking cramp! Ah! Alright, I'm gonna try five more times on this, and if I can't complete it, I've gotta move on. I'm moving on to one of Welshie's levels. Or Jean-Pierre if he's in the chat. Ah, oh, Bob! Alright. Four. Oh. Ah, damn it. Ah, bugger. Fuckity fuck, fuck, fuck. Oh, this is hard. This is harder than diamond coated Wolverine claws. Yes! Why? Why? Oh no, 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 that was No. All right. One more try, and then I think after that one, I think I'm gonna have to move on to another level. Let's give it one more try and move on. Oh, so close! Ah, one more, just one more. Oh, I'm getting better at this. I can't stop. Fuckity fuck. All right. Two more tries and that's it. That is honestly it. That. Oh god. No, okay. Two more tries after this because I gave up half of my turn there. All right. Hit. Grab. Ah, oh, damn it. All right. Start over. Sit up straight, bitch. Whoa, fucking hell. All right. Ah. Ah, no. All right. Well, this is the last try. The official last fuck. Yeah. All right, I'll give it a star because that is, fuck, that is hard. That is, dude, this is really, really hard. If you're watching this like afterwards, cause I know you're not in the chat right now because you can't be near your computer. You just tweeted that at me, but. Good God, this is hard, and you should be proud. Like, this is extremely difficult, but it's beatable. And I will return and do this next week, first time around. This could be the new Sky Climb. Sky Climb was of course, if you don't know, that I used to do every sort of time I started it up. I do it for the first little run while we got people into the chat. So this is going to be my new Sky Climb. This one, what's it called again? More Money 2, Get Rich and Die Trying. Is going to be the new default course that I start and try for the first 10 minutes of every stream. Welshy has tweeted at me like 10 courses, each based on a Mega Man level. So, which is very interesting. We're going to start off with Metal Man's one, then Airman, Woodman, and a bunch of others. We've also got Jean-Pierre's one, which I actually may do Jean-Pierre's one first. Just because, or Welshy's one actually, because he's in the UK, so. Let's get this show on the road. Don't forget to follow, by the way. Wow, shit. I love a bit of Mario World. Although Mario Brothers and Mario 3 are the two games I play the most, Mario 3 is my favorite 2D Mario game, my favorite being the original Mario Galaxy. Interesting. Oh, that's probably a shell I had to kick off there. Not myself. Probably not a good idea to kick myself off the edge of a cliff. In the video game or in real life. That's pretty fucking cool. Okay. Do I have to sacrifice Yoshi already? No. Ah, I know what I have to do. Oh, wait, hang on. That's not working. Ah. No. Okay. Nope. Nope, I got no idea. Oh, you can eat the fire? Oh shit, so you can! See, they add things into this game which you couldn't do in the original, like... you couldn't do that in Mario World, for example. Oh shit, what am I doing? Stop eating the... Yoshi! Bad Yoshi! I have a friend called Yoshi. Thank you. Ooh, shake, shake the wall. And I'm fiery. I'm fire. I'm a fiery motherfucker. Can I eat the yellow Yoshi with a Yoshi? No? Okay. Never mind. I'm keeping the Yoshi ahead. Okay, alright. Yeah! How I roll! How I pound! How I boom! What the fuck? Bugger! Petros is gangster lingo. Right. I'm part of the P unit. Because I'm Petros and my name begins with a P. Actually, I'm taking part of the L unit, which is Leon Film. What company? That's how I roll. That's how I do that level, yeah? Still do that level, yeah? What the fuck am I saying? And that's another by Jean-Philippe, so I'm gonna give that one a star. That was quite fun, quite interesting. I'd like to see more of that from you, Jean-Philippe. More of those like kind of like interesting puzzles of like trying to figure out how to solve the next bit and get the next part. I mean, you don't get to see that very often in Mario. Mario can be kind of a bit of a run like crazy. Hunter Goba, thank you for that course. That will be we will have that one next up in line after the first course by Welshy. Because that's what's next up. Yours is third in the queue right now, or second in the queue right now. Well, it could technically be fifth, but I'll move yours up above three of Welshy's, and we'll play yours next. Great. Uh-oh. Well, that was dumb. Come on, I can do this. You can do this. Run, 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 run. Well, what the fuck am I going to do there? I'm a bit foggy on my Mega Man game. I got what the hell? Fucking Mega Man. As if Mario wasn't fucking hard enough, I had to make it more like Mega Man. The game that I literally described in my series as fucking rigged. Fuck! Why can't I get through that gap? I essentially just bounce off it like it's a force field or something. Are there force fields in this game now? I don't know. Mario's always introducing new shit in this game. Spin jump, that's how you roll. Well, at least I got through. Oh, that is tricky. Do not get fire, go up to the top. What? Oh, smart thinking there, Hunter. Not smart playing, Petros. Fuck. Well, that was dumb. That was really fucking stupid. Hey, Killer Shadows, welcome to the chat. Now, I'm currently playing one of Welshie's levels. Based on Metal Man from Mega Man 2. He's made 4 different courses. You can check out this course in the bottom left of the screen. Here is the course ID. Ooh. Oh, and I think I'm skipping most of the course now. Oh, bugger. Yeah, there's no way for me to get up there, I don't think. Yeah, I can't get up. Sorry, Hunt, a smart idea, but, let's try doing the main course again. I think it's very possible. Whoa! Whoa, shit, fuck, too many moles. Too many moles. That's gonna be cooked shit, this is weird. I only finally saw that for the first time like about a month ago, and it was like, both hilarity and fear all rolled into one. Fuck, no, not the other way. Oh, shit. Well, fuck. Start over. Not gonna run away back there. All right. Come on, run to the edge and spin jump. Spin jump for your life. Just run like the wind. Run like a man, run like you're running on a trap. Fuck! Yeah, this is a toughie. But I've beaten Metal Man on Mega Man 2, I could beat him on Mario as well. Even if it was designed by a Welshman. Alright, here it is. Well, shit! Fuck! Ah! Oh. My fingers are not as fast as they used to be. Can't quite hit that B button as fast as I would like. Pull the trigger button. I think that's why I like Trace Civilization these days, because it doesn't actually require me to do anything that requires, like, fast-moving hands. It's just, requires strategy. Well, she's caught. Well, this is his Metal Man one. Oh, yes. All right. And I forgot the check mark. Fuck, I'm falling down. Hang on a second. I got an idea, guys. Alright, let's get this up. Hang on. Metal Man theme. Alright, I'm gonna play the Metal Man theme in the background just so I can, bit of inspiration while I'm playing this level. Oh shit. Fuck. Ah! Close. Do. Oh, okay. That's tricky because I don't have a power up of any kind here, so. Damn. I can do this. Thank you for following. Can always use more followers on Twitch. I think we're getting close to 50. Let's hit 50 if we can. Followers. Man, this ain't easy. It's not easy being blue and red. That's a rhyme as well. Fuck! Ugh! Come on. Run. Fuck, what am I doing? Oh, wait, what? Hang on. The video and audio is off. Shouldn't be. Come on. As in my audio or the game's audio? I literally just bought a fucking Elgato. Better not be fucking up on me already. Come on! let them walk off a cliff and jump. Yeah. Yeah. Wow, they move faster. Oh, here it is. Wow, Jesus, fuck! Whoa, what the fuck? Ah. Come on. Not giving up now, not giving up now. Fuck! I always forget that one moves a little bit faster, so I get flung off the edge. Fucking Bowser, like a giant Bowser waiting for you at the end of the fucking level. I think I'd rather face Metal Man, honestly. And if you know, Metal Man has no specific resistance to heat. Huh? Because, you know, you play the game and he has no resistance to heat. In Mega Man 2. The Heat Man's gun. Come on. Alright, come on. I can do this. Ah! That's such a tricky little section. It's about a second off. What, you mean my reaction? Yeah. I've noticed my reaction with my camera is a little bit off, and I'm not entirely sure why exactly, honestly. I can't figure that out at all, to be perfectly honest. Ah! I mean, the audio for the game is turned way down, so I don't know if you can't hear that, but... Whoo! Made it through. Come on, come over here. Alright. We'll get down to the lower level, you spin jump off it. Spin jump! Spin jump! Falcon jump! I've been playing too much Smash Brothers. Falcon launch! So there should be a checkpoint there because you get to fight, because you always respawn right next to the boss. Oh, come on, jump up when I'm actually heading towards you for once! God damn it. Alright, alright. I'm gonna change the Metal Man theme to something else. More Metal Man theme remix. Let's... Let's try this. Come on. Ah! Tilapia and fries for dinner. That sounds good. That sounds good. If you like lemon, I recommend as a dressing for the tilapia, a lemon, olive oil, and salt, pepper, and some Dijon mustard all mixed together. It's a good dressing for tilapia. Damn it! Come on. I can do this. No! Have none of that. Well, then just try salt and pepper. That works pretty well too. Yeah, tilapia's pretty cheap. It's a good firm fish, but I'm not even that big of a fan of fish, honestly. Like, I just generally like the ones that taste more like meat. Cause I like meat. I like meat in my mouth. Raising. Oh, what was that? That was my just idiocy there. Come on. Give us 5 more tries. I can beat this course. Alright, this first one. Let him walk off the cliff. Run underneath. Let them come down again. I think we're about to run out of metal, man. What the hell is it playing? The Mega's Metal Man. All right. Mega Man boss. Theme, Mega Man 2 boss theme. Alright, let's do this. Yes! Underneath him! Go, go, go! Now, excuse me, I just have to get something else on for this momentous moment. Ready, and... yeah, that works. That works. Play this course. Alright. Fire flower up there. Okay. Ugh. Tricky. It's tricky. No! If I hadn't spun there, I would have landed alright. Jump and spin, jump and spin, jump and spin. Jump and spin! Yeah, I can go down. What I'm going down into, on the other hand, is on the pipe. Well, I feel like I won that too easily. Alright, I'm gonna give that one a start. But we're gonna try it again. Let's try it again. I'm gonna beat the world record on it. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go in fact I'm gonna go the long way around this time. We'll see what happens. Alright, play again. Shit. Oh, I don't beat the world record that way, am I? Jump and jump and spin. And jump and spin. And jump and spin. And jump and spin. Jump and spin. Jump and spin. Fuck!
Oh, no.
Do the hard way. I'm gonna do it the hard way. It's always much more fun to do it the hard way, you know? Just going down that pipe made it too easy for me. Like a challenge. Like the struggle. Fuck!
Oh, no!
But not quite the... You finished it in 8 seconds. Well, you made the course, so of course you finished it in 8 seconds. I am just a lowly random Twitch streamer. I do not have time for such things, and bugger. Actually, I have a few world records. Not a ton, but like 6 or 7. Mostly on friends' courses. And for a very brief moment, I held the world record on one of the event courses, and then it got beaten like 10 seconds later. But I managed to snap a photo in time. Fuck! All right. Jump and spin. 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 Run. Oh no!
Oh no!
I forgot to do the jump part before I did the spin part. Alright. I can do this. Words of encouragement. I can do this. Words of encouragement. Yes. Made it across. Alright. No! Alright, give this 5 more tries, then I'm gonna have to move on, because I've already beaten it regularly, so. I've been having a weird craving to play Final Fantasy VIII lately. How do you submit a level? Just post it on the chat, or tweet it at me, which is at PetrosAsparta. You can see it. There now. Yeah, it's just right about here. But there. Yeah, that's it. Right there. Right there. You can either tweet it at me, or you can just post the course ID in the chat, and I will happily play it. In fact, I may play it next. I may play a World 2-1 next, depending on which one where I get first. Fuck!
Oh no!
Alright, 3 more tries. 3 more tries on this. Then I'm moving on. We go ground to cover. Thank you very much for that one. That'll be the next course I play. And Boshi, I will play his courses more frequently if he actually joined the chat. But he doesn't have a Twitch ID, apparently, by the looks of things. No Twitch ID, no chat! Oh, damn it.
Oh, no!
Damn it! Well, let's do the extra hard way. No, that's not. It's actually technically no harder, but it's like, it makes it feel harder because there's no ground beneath you. It's like those things in Mario 1 where like you'll be getting up towards the end. There's actually no harder than just the ones where like there was a slight gap because it just looked harder because there was nothing holding up the floating blocks. Oh, fucking.
Oh, no.
Oh, well. By the way, if you're enjoying what you're watching, please go ahead and click that follow button below. And, follow me on Twitch. Twitch.tv/Petros of Sparta. I do weekly Mario Maker streams every Monday at 3 p.m. Although, because I may be moving back to the UK, I may be rearranging that time. Although, 11 p.m. in the UK is not so bad. I may have to move it a bit earlier, honestly, just because that's an early as hell stream. All right. I think I'm gonna move on from this one onto Everyday Gamers course, which is up next. I've given this one a star, so let's move along. Yes, I do have an Instagram. My Instagram is @PetrosOfSparta. I believe the last thing I posted was a message about this. This is your course. Or... I'm guessing you live in Japan. Oh, good lord. Wait, I think I've seen this course before. I think I can still see which one I am. Alright, I see which one I am still. I lose myself every few minutes, but... this. Yes, I'll post the Instagram name in the chat. It's the exact same as the Twitter and Facebook. So yeah, go ahead and check that out if you want to. The exact same focus on which one I am here. It's really hard to keep track, but... Oh, I've moved it over. Come on. I need to bounce stuck in this area now. Oh, no. Damn, I knocked it back over. I believe it is actually harder to hit this thing than it is to... come on. Yes, alright. Up there. And through here, yeah. Boink. And I did it. Yeah. Ugh. I need to friggin' stretch. You follow me 2 times. Nice. Doesn't seem so bad. not that bad. Doesn't seem too impossible. This has been touted as a stage no one has beaten. But I beg to differ. I've done the impossible before. Beaten a course that no one has ever beaten before as well. Not that I'm touting my actual Mario skills, because honestly I really wouldn't do that too much. You may have noticed I introduced myself on this course by saying I'm going to die a lot on it. Oh, that's actually pretty empty. You can easily sweep up there. Okay. Oh, I lost my power up. Oh well. Oh, damn!
Oh, no.
Fucking Goomba's coming out of the woodwork. Slide down. Oh, well, that was stupid of you, Petros. Let's start this again, because that was fucking stupid. So some people do that when they give you a mushroom to start. You can actually start the course by giving Mario a mushroom before the course begins, and they start, like, powered up. I believe. I believe in a thing called love. Just listen to the rhythm of my heart. Oh, whoopsie. That was a mistake. Let's try and get all the way to the left. Nope, I dropped it again. Oh, this is, you know, I'm just gonna fucking start over because I fucked that up. How much for Elgato? The Elgato is about 150 bucks. When you can get them cheaper, I would personally recommend the one I'm using is the HD60, which is like the second best one. The best one being the Elgato HD60 Pro. So they have oh bugger, I did it again. So they have a number of different models of the Elgato. I used to use a Roxio, but now I'm back to using Elgato, and now I'm using Elgato again. They range from about 120 to about 200 bucks, depending on which model you get. I got the one that was about 180 regular, but I got it for. I got it discounted on Amazon for about 140. Plus I had a discount card as well, which is pretty handy. For Amazon idea. I finally took my one of those piggy bank things that I had that I'd been saving all my coins up in for a while. All my loose change in for a while and took it to Coinstar. Got an Amazon ticket for it. The 60fps one, yeah, that's about 140, about 180 regular. I think they have it for 154 on Amazon right now. If you check it out, it's a great device. Honestly, it is the simplest setup. It does not work with 64-bit. That's an advanced. It only works for some reason with 64-bit Elgato's pre-made software. It doesn't work with Elgato's. It doesn't work with OBS 64-bit, which is what I use. So just be mindful of that when you.
Oh, no.
Fucking Goomba's the bane of my existence. Just be mindful of that. It doesn't work at 64-bit. But it does work on 64-bit computers. Like, that's what I'm using right now. I'm just using the 32-bit version of OBS. I believe they're working on a bug for this, on a fix for this. I believe the Pro works 64-bit, but the regular HD, Elgato HD60 does not work with 64-bit OBS. It is a great, great capture card though. I've had no issue with it so far. Honestly, way less lag, and granted I improved my internet and everything connection since then as well, but when I had my Roxio, there was audio issues, there was lag. Although ironically, a little while back, a friend of mine was shooting at the studio I was working at, operating at, a friend of mine, Megan, was shooting there, and she her Elgato for some reason stopped working one day, so we gave her my Roxio to work, and it worked just fine. Since then, however, it started having issues, and after that, I upgraded to the Elgato. It's nice, it's small and convenient. It's a great little device, honestly. I'm personally very happy with my purchase. And if they want to sponsor me, I'll happily talk about just sing even more of their praises and give away Elgatos and things like that and do giveaways. I actually had a giveaway prize, but I accidentally used it on myself. Yeah, I have the HD60 one. I'm not playing at 60 frames a second right now, but I'm going to see what I can do to fix that going forward. I have 200 down internet and 20 up. Oh shit, what did I do? I have 20 down, 200 down, 20 up internet with Time Warner Cable. Although, Google Fiber is coming to LA. Although I may not be here for that. So I'm personally looking forward to start over. But like right now, from what I understand, 20 down is fine. And 60 frames a second. My only concern is that my computer does have a tendency to overheat occasionally, and I don't want that to happen midstream, because it has happened before. Back when I was streaming BioShock one time. Granted, I had my second screen plugged in to see if I could get some second screen action going on, because you can't really look at the chat with anything but your phone, really, unless you are the second screen. I have an old laptop, so. Illuminati Fallout. Okay. I'll buy it. What? Huh? What are you talking about? I have not played Fallout in a while. I should play. I mean, I've been meaning to get Fallout 4 and give the Bethesda series a new chance. I mean, it was kind of funny. Fallout 3 came out, and I got kind of excited after watching it that I went and that in the weeks coming up to it, I went back and played Fallout 1 and 2. And I fucking loved them, because I never played Fallout 1 and 2 before. And Fallout 3 looked kind of exciting. So I went back and played the others to really get into it, like you do. And it was this great tactical RPG, and I really enjoyed it, and I had a great time. Then I played Fallout 3, and I fucking hated it, even though that was the game I'd been getting excited for, because they'd, like, dumbed it down to lowest common denominator-style gameplay for me. Like, it was no longer really an RPG so much as it was an FPS, or, like, Elder Scrolls with guns, which is not a bad thing necessarily, but like I think I was just a bit butthurt over the fact that it wasn't Fallout 3, basically. It wasn't a Fallout game in my mind. I never played New Vegas because I just didn't, but I hear that was actually for people who like the original Fallout, so that's much better. Much more story driven and interesting. Fallout 4, I have not played yet, but I've been thinking about giving another shot. And no, I'm not a member of the Illuminati. Not anymore. Yeah. Slow and steady wins the fuck. Kicking, jump and fall and slide. Lots of coins and Goombas. Oh, I think I've made it. I think I'm going to be the first person to ever beat this level. Should I get cocky and try and get the one up? Should I? No, don't do it. Don't do it, Petros. You're going to fuck up. First person to beat this level, officially the world record holder. I'm just going to tweet at the people who told me it was unbeatable. I appear to have had a lot of free time lately, given the recent news that I just got. Jump over. Fuck! What's the Airman stage? I should be playing Airman music. What am I doing? Airman theme. Reduce the Elgato down again. Let's do this. Shit. This is very Airman. Fuck. So many bullets. Oh, hit by a hammer, bro. Ah, this is the Smash Brothers remix of Airman stage, by the way. Fucking Mega Man, just like, they fucking killed it with that soundtrack. Man, Capcom used to be like the bastion of fucking the greatest games, like third-party games, in the world. Fucking Street Fighter, Mega Man, Breath of Fire, fucking, like... Come on. Whoa, shit! What the fuck? I have a bizarre fondness for Square Enix, which is irrational because they have destroyed most of my childhood. Although, you know what? I'll be honest, this is not the same Square Enix about 5-6 years ago now. Since the new leadership took over, they seem to be really, like... I mean, between a Final Fantasy VII remake and their mobile games getting, like, infinitely better than they were, like, just a couple of years ago. And you remember fucking all the Bravest. That was a goddamn travesty. It was a blight upon gaming. But if you, I'm gonna turn this down a little bit so I can. But if you ever get a chance, if you have a phone, I recommend Final Fantasy Record Keeper. It's a lot of fun if you're a Squeenix fan like me. I've been having this weird craving to play the PS1 Final Fantasies lately, and we have it. Awesome. You can add me on there as well. I believe in Petros and Sparta on there as well. Oh no, they give you a fake ID. Don't they? They give like some weird fucking like numerical ID, friend code bullshit on that. I'll post it in the chat at the end. Oh shit! I'm actually really looking forward to Final Fantasy IX coming out on Steam. I'm going to stream that. What I've been wanting to stream actually is Final Fantasy VII on balls on PC. Shit! Ugh. Yeah, I heard of that. I never played it, but like I had a few friends who said it was fucking amazing. I never got the chance to play The World Ends with you. There was a brief period where I went, I think between the ages of sort of 16 and 20-ish, that I kind of got out of gaming a little bit. And it was a retro game that really brought me back to the good side of the force. And that was Chrono Trigger. Played Chrono Trigger for the first time when I was 20. And fell in love with it. And to this day, it is the only other like Square game I've managed to get my brother to play outside of Final Fantasy VII. My brother is a huge Final Fantasy VII fan. I'm sure one day you guys will get to meet him, probably fairly soon. My brother is a huge Final Fantasy VII fan, as am I. It's our favorite game of all time. He refused to play any games after that, though. He wasn't a fan of 8. And I'll be honest, I definitely have my issues with 8. But... Ah! No! Yeah, Chrono Trigger is absolutely fucking beautiful. But I managed to get... I gave him Chrono Trigger DS for his birthday once, I think, when I came back from New York, when I first lived in New York and I moved back to London for a year. I got my brother Chrono Trigger. I got it from in America. Because back then, you could get a DS game in America and play it in the US. And on a UK 3DS. You can't fucking do that on the 3DS because that's bullshit. Hope this new NX thing actually gets rid of fucking region lock, finally. God damn it! Anyway, he played Chrono Trigger. He didn't actually manage to beat the game because he'd lost his charger for his DS. And just after a while... thing about DS games is that, like, any video game really is, like, when you stop playing it, you stop, basically. Like, if you go a couple of months without playing it, it takes a while to get back into it. He just picked up the Epoch, so he was quite far in. Which is the time ship. I forgot I had firepower. Not anymore, I don't. See, the advanced thing here is that Mega Man actually has a gun. Oh! No! Wow, well, okay. Go through the gun! Oh! Why can't I go through the pipe? I got no idea there. Yeah. Final Fantasy VII, like, JRPGs are my favorite kind of game, honestly. My favorite game of all time is Final Fantasy VII. My second favorite is Xenoblade Chronicles, the original one for the Wii. Followed closely by a Japanese action RPG, which is Zelda Skyward Sword. And no, I'm not a new guy to the series. I've been playing it since fucking Zelda 2. I didn't get to play the original back in the day. I did discover something very interesting the other day, which is if you go to Etsy.com, you can find a whole bunch of modded NES cartridges and Super NES games. And they're all available. They're like $50. I mean, you can download the ROM and everything for those same games, but it's not quite the same as being able to play them on a fucking cart on your original Super Nintendo. It's just, like, I think it's just fucking awesome that people have gone to that level. I mean, they cost a fucking lot of money. It's like $50. Like, probably just... Ah, same thing as before. Oh shit! God damn it, Welshly! Alright. I'm gonna give this course 5 more tries, then I might have to pick it up next week. Such a fucking tune. And the Breath of Fire series is one of my favorites, and a series I long to return to, honestly. I wish they made more Breath of Fire games again. Because that series was fucking great. Like, people look at the time and were like, oh, it's kind of like standard JRPG fare. It's not. It had some great fucking systems, like the ability to create your own dragon modifications, and like, the gameplay, yeah, the basic battle system was pretty Super Nintendo JRPG basic, but some of the story in those games was really fucking well done. Like, I mean, it's, not to say, whoa, deep man, or anything like that, but it's like, Breath of Fire 3 was basically about the search for God. Like, literally, and ask him why he made me into a man. Like, it was why God would ask someone to kill people. Breath of Fire 4 was about, like, was basically this shit. Breath of Fire 4 was basically the story of, a kind great emperor that no one wants around, so he turns into a villain. But you play as the emperor, and it's it was great. And then Dragon Quarter happened, and yeah, I bought that like several years ago, but never actually played it. Ironically, ah, no. Ah! No! Don't forget, you can play these courses by checking out the bottom left of these. You'll find this gets uploaded to YouTube probably tonight or tomorrow. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Ah! What am I doing? Alright. 3 more tries and I'm done. So this is try number 3. Damn it. Fuck. 2 more tries. Let's not count that as a try because I lost my concentration on the stream. Looking down at the chat for a second. Stop flaming! This is a fucking tune. Ah! All right, one more try. One more try. One more try after that, because that was a fuck up. Run and jump. Ah, damn it. I could do this. Oh, yeah. Shit. Yeah, checkpoint. All right. If I hit the checkpoint, I gotta do this. I gotta do this the real way, you know? Where should I fuck? How is there not a Mega Man maker? Fuck! Oh, there was supposed to be Mega Man Universe, but they fucking ditched that idea. Yeah, look who's fucking laughing now. Well done, Capcom. Genius idea. Oh, wait, hang on. Nah. I want the proper, I want the remix. What the fuck? Jesus Christ! No! Oh! Hey, look, guys. What, you delayed a game? Like, look, at the end of the day, look, this fight might be number nine. Look, I'm gonna fucking release a video on my YouTube channel and talk about this, but I'm gonna talk about it right now, alright? Look. Here's the thing about Inafune. Is the truth. He has developed some fucking brilliant games over the years. Mighty No. 9 looks like it's going to be a fucking great game, and yes, he delayed it again. But would you rather have a broken game or a game that that works a bit later? Let's be perfectly honest. How many times have people fucking complained about about games being broken and having day one DLC and day one patches and all that bullshit? Come on, let's be real here, guys. But speaking of someone who has done a Kickstarter and, as Janet will fucking testify, had difficulty sometimes fulfilling my rewards, let alone the fucking show. It is not an easy thing to deal, and especially not with all the fucking nerd rage out there. Specifically directed towards a guy who just wanted to help make a game. Yeah, exactly. That's what happened with Five Nights at Freddy's. It turned out to be absolute bullshit. Exactly. It's... Oh God, come on! Hello, Wither Archer. You have unfortunately arrived right at the very end of the stream. Ah! Damn. Just trying to beat this level. This is based on Airman's level from... it's by Welshy. It's based on the Airman's level from Mega Man 2. He's got two more that I'm going to play next week. Look, yeah, like at the end of the day, a bad game is a broken game is bad forever. Sorry, Wither Archer. Yeah, that Bowser is fucking big. Hey, too few secrets. I can beat this guy. I can fucking beat this guy. I beat him last time. Yeah, but it's the exact same thing, Damo. It's basically, look, we could get the game tomorrow, but it would be not as good as it would be in a couple of months. That's the truth. And I know this because like I had to push back the release of video game multiple times, not just to several episodes, but the initial release was supposed to be out 6 months earlier. I intended to have it out by May, and I could try fireballing him to death, but it's fucking difficult. I've tried running under him, it's just a bit easier. I'll try fireballing him. Just keep my distance. And fireball him. What the? Yeah, keep shooting him up. Just fly already. Ah! But yeah, the point is at the end of the day, it's a. It's difficult to make games. Making video games is a process that, like, few will understand. I do. I personally have been in game development before, so I understand the process. And I know what it's like doing Kickstarter and people have demands from you and stuff, so I think I'm gonna manage to fireball him to death here. Oh, no, damn it. Yes, he's up there! Run, 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 run! Yeah! Mega Man. Hope you guys like that. I hope you've enjoyed the stream today. Please go ahead and check it out. Please follow me on Twitch and on YouTube, on Facebook and everything, and Instagram too, and all the different social media. Hope you guys like this, and I hope to see you guys soon. I'm really enjoying doing these Twitch streams, and I may start doing it more than once a week. We've been considering setting up a proper Leon film stream. I've got a buddy of mine, Kyle, who was the guy asking for coffee in that video just now. He and I have been thinking about setting up some streams. Unfortunately, we need to get internet in his apartment first before we do that. So we've been thinking about doing some new stuff, some new Twitch streams. We've been thinking about doing some new shorts. So a lot of cool different stuff we're going to be doing soon. So, hope to see you guys soon. And please don't forget to follow, like, subscribe, follow, and follow more. All right. Hope to see your sexy faces sometime soon.